Good morning, students. Hope you all are doing well and safe. So, in the today's online lecture, we will discuss about the superficial mycoses. As now you are familiar with the word mycosis. The word mycosis states that it is the disease caused by the pathogenic fungus. So, the superficial mycoses will be the superficial disease caused by the pathogenic fungus. Superficial mycoses are usually confined to the outermost layer of the skin, hair, mucosa, and they do not invade inside the living tissue. The upper layer, the epidermis part of the skin, is linked with the superficial mycoses. So, this type of mycosis is very common. Commonly, this type of mycosis is known as tinea or ringworm. This affects mainly skin, hair, and nails. So, the superficial mycosis, superficially what you have, skin, hairs, and nails. So, this kind of fungal disease mainly involves skin, hair, and disease. They are specialized saprophytes. Saprophytes means they act upon dead decaying matters. The dead decaying part of the skin, that is keratin, they act upon the keratin and try to digest that keratin which is present in the skin, hair, and nail. So what is the specific characteristics of a superficial mycosis? That is, they act upon dead surface of the skin and its appendages. They do not have a contact with the living tissue. So they do not come in contact with the living tissue and they do not elicit the immune responses. And there is no discomfort because they only act upon the dead surface. You cannot feel it. So there is no discomfort. Only cosmetic problem is there. You just see it, the infection superficially, but you do not feel it. So it is limited to the stratum corneum of the skin. So kya hai superficial mycosis? Jo ऊपर ऊपर की सतह पर जो इन्फेक्शन और डिजीज होगी आपकी स्किन के, उसको हम सुपरफिशियल माइकोसिस बोलेंगे. ये अंदर तक नहीं जाएगी, आपके जो लिविंग टिश्यू है उनको इफेक्ट नहीं करेगी, इसीलिए कोई भी इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स जनरेट नहीं करेगी. नो डिस्कम्फर्ट, कोई भी डिस्कम्फर्ट नहीं होगा. So, आप सुपरफिशियल माइकोसिस और क्यूटेनियसिस और डीप माइकोसिस को कैसे डिफ्रेंशिएट कर सकते हो? सुपरफिशियल माइकोसिस, द इन्फेक्शन अकर्स ऑन द डेड लेयर ऑफ द स्किन, वेयर एज इन द डीप इट कन्फर्ड टू द लिविंग टिश्यू ऑफ द स्किन. हेयर देर इज नो इन्फ्लामेटरी रिस्पॉन्स. हेयर द इन्फ्लामेट इन द डीप इन्फ्लामेटरी रिस्पॉन्सेज विल बी generated, that such as hypersensitivity will be there. The example of the superficial mycosis is tinea versicolor, tinea nigria, pedaria white, and pedaria nigria. Whereas the example of the deep mycosis is dermatophytosis and candida infection. In this video lecture, I will be discussing about tinea versicolor. In the next lectures, we will discuss about tinea nigria, pedaria white, pedaria nigria, and the deep mycosis. So today we will focus on the tinea versicolor. Tinea versicolor or pityriasis versicolor, tinea felvar, dermatomycosis, liver spot or perfumerans, these are the other names of this disease. This is the superficial infection of the horny layer of the skin, that is, it clear out the skin part, and it is caused by a fungi named Melastesia furfur. And this major site where it causes the disease, the chest, the abdomen, thighs, and the back. what kind of clinical presentation of this disease? How will you see this kind of infection? In this kind of infection, what happens? Flown white superficial patches are there. The white patches of skin will be there. There will be sharp margins between the patches, and it can scale out, cover with the scales, but there is no inflammatory, no itching, and it is a cosmetic problem. So this kind of patches, as shown in the figure, you will see this kind of patches due to this infection. This infection will not harm you, will not cause any problem to you, but it is a cosmetic problem. So let us take a case history. A 17-year-old boy come to a hospital and says he sees a discolored patches on the skin, back, arms and legs, but these patches were not itching and there is no discharge. They spread over time, period of time, but they are spreading and the patient is fine otherwise with no complaints. So with this kind of description, you can think of the tinea versicula, that no itching is there, no discomfort is there, so it is superficial. There is discolored patches, some kind of infection is there, but what kind of infection is there, whether it is a fungal or it is a bacterial infection, then you will go for the examination of this person. Then this kind of infection is further, the causative agent can cause various kind of infections in this, that is versicular, pterylis folliculitis and seborrheic dermatitis and systemic infection. You have learned about the vascular. In this you have seen that there is a pigmentation will be there on the skin surface. But in the pterylis folliculitis, in this what happened, the follicular papules or pustules will be there on the back, chest and the upper arm. Sometimes it can be seen on the neck and the face. They are itchy and often appear after the sun exposure. Where in the seborrheic dermatitis, what happened, the sebum gland composition get changed, it increase the wax production and shift from the triglyceride to the shorter fatty acids will be there. So because of this, there is increase in the alkalinity of the skin and there will be scalpy or scaly like sebaceous gland will be there. The scales of the white scales will be seen on the scalp, face, eyebrow, ears and the trunk. Itchy scalp will be there, like dandruff type of scalp. You see the scalp when your dead skin will be there on the scalp because of the less application of the oil, etc. You see this kind of infection. How will you diagnose this infection? First of all, you will take the sample. You will take the skin scraping. Through the skin scraping with the help of a sharp blade. Then first you will see this under the wood slab, under the ultraviolet radiation, how it shows. It will show green fluorescent color or blue fluorescent color patches under the wood slab if it is a superficial mycosis. Then you will go for the further confirmatory test like microscopy. In that you will do the KOH, 10% KOH test preparation. You will prepare a slide with the 10% KOH. You will take the sample. You will prepare the slide with the 10% KOH. Then you will see it under the microscope. What kind of structures are being seen? If the structures are spiny or ball-like appearance, then you can say that it is a superficial mycosis infection. Then you can go for the culturing also on the STA sucrose, dextrose agar, and you can see the growth of the causative agent on the medium, and from that growth you can confirm that this is a superficial mycosis. Then how you can manage this superficial mycosis? You can take the topical agents like amidazoles, etc., oral treatments, and both the topical and oral treatments can be combined, and different lotions, etc., can be used to suppress these infections. Thank you for the today. So in the today we have discussed about the Tinea versicola, which is a superficial infection, and it is a infection of the dead skin. Now in the next video lecture I will be discussing you the other, the Tinea nigeria and Pidera white or Pidera black. So stay tuned, stay safe.